Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot's with the final video of 2015 here on the channel, and we are going to do like a year in review. Let's do some words. A year in review. Yeah, I'm going to spell review like a weird person. How do I want to do it? Review. It's French. Year in review for the channel. So what have we done over the past year, and what are the goals for 2016? What direction is the channel going to go in, and what's been good and what's been bad over the past year and stuff like that. So we're going to start things off in the first half of the video looking at 2015 and our sort of progression and what you guys have enjoyed and what I've enjoyed and maybe what's not worked out so well and what we're going to try to do better in the future. I am making this up absolutely as I go along, and it's 6:30 in the morning, so I'm a little bit fuzzy-headed at the moment, to say the least, so it may be an incoherent mess. Let's find out. So, starting off with 2015. Well, the first things first, my goal, we should talk about the goals. So the goal for 2015, originally, because we started the year on about 130k subscribers. And subscribers is kind of, and the growth rate is kind of just how I measure how the channel is doing in general. So we started on about 130k, and we're now on 285k. And considering the channel has existed for about 4 years, that is a I think it might have been slightly more than 130k. But either way, that is a ginormous jump up. Absolutely massive. And you know what? It wasn't, because I got my 100k subscriber thing like this time last year. So it must have been around there. The channel's been going for 4 years, yet in the last year, I've gained over half of my total subscribers. So it's been a really good year on that front. And my original goal for the year was actually only 200k, and I thought that might be a little bit optimistic. So before we talk about anything else, I want to thank you guys, everyone who's new, everyone who is part of that new 155k, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you've had a good year, I hope you've enjoyed your time here on the channel, and hopefully 2016 is going to be even better, because we've got some big plans, which we're going to talk about in a minute. And that must be said, that this has basically been my subscriber growth throughout 2015. Actually, there should be jumps every now and again, because Saturdays are always really good days. So it kind of looks something like that, I don't know. And then you get to about June, and it goes... and it stays there for a little bit, and then it goes like that. That is basically 2015 in a nutshell. This bit here is about 16... I'm going to try to be open and honest with you guys about this whole thing. That's about 16,000 subscribers a month, that's about 8k. And where we are now, it's started to go up a little bit, but that's about 6k. Something happened here. Something happened here, and I don't know what either of these events were, I'm not gonna lie. I have no idea what happened at these points to generate this difference. I don't think I did anything differently. Oddly enough, the growth actually occurred when I wasn't here. This was mainly my time off in Costa Rica and such, so that's even more confusing for me. Anyways, and then it dropped massively, and I don't know why it dropped massively either. I don't know if I did anything wrong or whatever, but that's just the way it is. You know, there's always gonna be drips and drabs, and it's always going to change and stuff like that, so that's fine, we can deal with that. At that point, which was up there, my goal actually became 300k, because I was kind of assuming the growth would stay relatively the same, and obviously it didn't, so we didn't quite hit it. We only fell 15k short, but it's worth remembering that compared to the original 200k, I know this is an absolute mess that you can barely read, it's just such a massive jump over anything I could have possibly expected. 4 years ago when I started this channel, sitting in my university room, doing my first year of biomedical science, I'll draw me as a scientist. Just so you know what biomedical science looks like. It looks like the geekiest thing you can imagine. Every time, what are you doing? Geeky, there I go, and I need a lab coat. I look like I'm wearing a skirt, and a little quiff, obviously, because it's me. So, I was in my first year of biomedical science, we kickstarted the channel with, actually we played Dead Island was the first thing we played. Let's draw Dead Island. I can't draw, by the way, in case that isn't coming through in the video. I have a very rough style. My art teacher hated me because of how I draw. Very, very rough. Always, like, when I draw things, I like to do this. I like to dash the lines, you know? I don't know why. Always been a thing. I don't know what this is, by the way. We'll make it into a cloud. Dead Island. Boop, 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 boop. It's an island, and it's dead. So, that's actually not bad. This is the first game we ever played on the channel. I did like 40 episodes in a few weeks, and they all got like 10 views each. The channel was nothing. About a year and a half later, once I'd become partnered, This is big business, man. Became partnered. Even then, I was on about 30,000 subscribers because Skyrim had kicked us off a little bit. Either way, it was probably less than a year, but that was about 30k. Oh my God. Either way, I never dreamed it would be anything. Even at the 30k, 40k point, the views were poor or whatever, and I actually considered quitting. I was going to leave YouTube. I actually sent an email to my partner manager saying, I am leaving, I'm not doing this anymore, so, you know, take me off your contract. Or keep me on the contract to the end, whatever, but there will be no new content, just so you know. And it terrifies me that, looking back, I was so close to quitting, because at the end of the day, guys, and this is the first year on the channel, 2015, boop, it's the first year I've ever really been sort of professional, you know, not in style or attitude or any of that, but just in professional, because professionals wear ties. The person is a tie, it's terrifying, it's like Human Centipede Project, but with ties. Basically, that should curve a bit, shouldn't it? So this is the first sort of professional year we've had, and the idea a few years ago that I could ever do this is absolutely bloody mental. So no matter what the bad stuff this year has been, maybe we had a little drop, maybe some other things have turned up that mean the channel isn't doing as well as I'd hope, or whatever, irrespective of all that, the fact that I can sit here and blab on like an utter idiot and you guys will sit there in your crazy selves like so, crazy eyes, and watch me blab on is unbelievably awesome, and I can't thank you guys enough for letting me do this as my career, as my job, for now at least, which I will also address in a minute. Don't panic. So anyways, in that way the channel did quite well this year. We also played some very, very cool games. What did we play this year? We played Godzilla, didn't we? Let's try draw Godzilla here. It should be noted, I don't really know what Godzilla looks like off the top of my head. Except he's big and he's spiny. He's got these and they glow, don't they? This is the first time I've had my tablet in a very long time. It's not a good tablet. It's just like a little Wacom Intius bamboo. It's not bamboo. It's the better one than the bamboo, but there's not much in it. I don't know why it's got too glow. There we go. Let's just pretend that's good Godzilla. Okay, he's a little thin. You could maybe eat some more mince pies, but there's Godzilla. We played Godzilla. That was really cool. We played, obviously, we kicked off the year with JPOG, so let's... I don't know what this is, but this is meant to be a fence for, like, the dinosaurs. Obviously, we started with JPOG, and obviously we'll be doing that again at some point in January. What else did we play this year? This year we also played Lucius with his little emo haircut. And that was such a long time ago. We played Lucius 2, I should say, in particular. That's Lucius with his little emo haircut and his... Satanic devil father. We also played Subnautica for the first time. That's underwater. What else did we play, folks? What else did we play? We played a lot of cool stuff this year, is what I'm trying to get across. And all of this, except JPOG, isn't dinosaur based. And obviously we played a lot of great dinosaur games as well. We tried some stuff like, say, Tomb Raider, which didn't really go that well, but we had the dinosaur level, which is kind of what matters. And we tried Power World until the game realised for the second time in history that it utterly hates me and never wants me to complete it, and stuff like that. We played some great dinosaur games over the year as well, including finishing off the Hunter Primal, which has added a new creature, which I'm hopefully going to set up so I can show you guys. They've added like a queen T-Rex, it's very cool. And yeah, so basically 2015, it's been very up and down year. You know, the growth over here isn't where I'd like it. I'd like it to be sort of up here. If we're going to hit 400k, that means we need about 10,000 subscribers a month, and the current rate is more like 7k, which isn't great, and we've definitely done better than that in the past. So hopefully we get to about the 10k mark, which means we'll hit 400k. My bigger goal is 500k by the end of this year. And that's optimistic. Let's give it a little face. It kind of looks like breasts. That's a little optimistic, but I think you always want to aim high, don't you? But the point I'm trying to make is, no matter where we land, if we get 500k, if we get 400k, if we get 300k, whatever, the fact that I can still sit here and do this job is just super duper cool. So let's draw a thumbs up. I can't draw hands. I can't draw at all. Thumbs up! It's awesome. I love that I can do this, and we could hit no more targets for the rest of my life. Everything could stay exactly the same, and as long as there's some crazy people at home watching, I will be a happy bunny. Now, one of the reasons, and this is going to link in with 2016, one of the reasons 2015 maybe hasn't gone quite to plan is potentially because, let's face it, I have more competition this year. There is now about four people, I'd say, who are fairly successful, who are all working in approximately the same niche. There's me, I'll give myself hair, everyone else can remain bald. There's obviously Gaming Beaver, there's obviously Poet Plays, there's another guy I completely can't remember the name of, but the point is dinosaurs have become a bigger thing this year. And that's great in a lot of ways. You know, the more people who watch this kind of stuff, the better it's going to be, the more dinosaur games we're going to get. Also, the success of Ark has actually been quite a bad thing from my perspective, just because it's got such strong crossover ties with survival games in general, which are very much wider played, you know, by channels who maybe wouldn't sit down and play Turok, but they would sit down and play Rust. That means Ark has been played by a lot of people, which means people who might traditionally go to dinosaur channels for this kind of content have instead gone to other types of channel. And I believe me, I'm not trying to sound bitter about this in the slightest. It is what it is. It's an open market. You've got to do well. You've got to try to survive. You've got to push your channel as much as you can. Because at the end of the day, there are so many YouTubers out there who don't make a living off it, who never probably will, who kind of scrape by, who desperately want to grow and grow, and just won't get the lucky break they need to make it a little bit bigger, you know? And I'm incredibly lucky to be able to do this full stop. So whilst there is more competition, in a lot of ways that's a good thing. And I don't really think of it as competition. At the end of the day, we're all just trying to kind of make it. And I think the channels that I've referenced, I think we're all very different in style and attitude towards the subject matter. To the point where I don't see that much crossover personally, but I know other people do. And I don't want any comments down below like, oh, I prefer such and such or such and such, or I like you compared to such and such. People have this innate desire to create like a war between YouTubers. You know, it's kind of a thing people love to do. Whereas us, as a community of YouTubers, don't really have the same... There's blood everywhere, okay? Bloodshed. Don't really have the same desire. We don't want to fight. We don't want to compete. We kind of just want to do our thing. I don't watch any other YouTuber at all, pretty much these days. I don't spend my time watching YouTubers. I've got no idea what they're doing. It's why I get so infuriated when people say I'm copying people. And I'm sure people get comments all the time saying, oh, you're copying BestInSlot's. And the fact is, probably people aren't. There's only so many games out there. And what I'd love in 2016, from you guys in particular, is just... If there's one request I have of you as a fan base, is to try to stop making it a thing in some ways. You know, we don't need this to be a war, we don't need this to be a competition, nobody has to be better than everyone else. We have different styles, that's all it is. People come to us for different reasons. But saying that, we're going to darken it up a little bit. So this right here is going to look like an awful pigeon, but it's meant to be a high pigeon, a Galapagos Finch kind of thing, which, as you'll know, is a very famous thing from Mr. Charles Darwin when he was that's so bad when he was discussing evolution. And that's kind of my point leading into 2016. Because of this increased competition, because there are people who are doing pretty much exactly the same thing I do in a different style perhaps, but because people have moved into my market, I need to evolve, we need to adapt for 2016, and we need to become the proverbial Galapagos finch. So, we're going to draw a house. And I'm going to allay some fears. So this right here is the foundation of the house. The BestInSlot's house. And the foundation is games. So I don't want people to panic and think the channel's going in a completely different direction or things are about to change too much. There's going to be some changes, but we'll see. We'll talk about that now. So the foundation will, as it always has, remain to be gaming, whether that's dinosaur games, like upcoming, well, we're playing The Isle, Mesozoica's in development, Prehistoric Kingdom, Dinosaur Battlegrounds, there's tons on the way. We just started playing Turok, Far Cry Primal is coming out, which I know is not technically dinosaurs, but it's close enough. There's a lot of cool stuff coming out in 2016, and there will inevitably be lots more stuff we haven't heard of yet, including potentially announcements of a new Turok game. Plus, No Man's Sky has dinosaurs in it, and I'm very excited. Games, dinosaur and otherwise, because there's plenty of non-dinosaur games I'm excited about as well to show and play with you guys, including, let's say, Fallout 4 at the moment. Let's draw Fallout 4. It's a nuke, sort of, and there's an unhappy man because he's being nuked, which isn't a good time for anyone. So games will always remain the foundation. That's what we do. We're gamers. That's why we're here. You know, for now at least, this is what the channel is about. We sit down, we play games, I talk rubbish over the top of them. That is why you're here, and that's why I can do this as a job. That's not about to change. However, as you saw with Pangea, if you can read that, this is why I should have been a doctor, because of my handwriting. That's the only real reason, but still. As you can see by... No, not as you can see. Pangea today was this attempt to do something a little bit different. It was educational. My goal was to break down a recently released scientific document, an article profiling the discovery of a new dinosaur, which I've completed. Zhejiang Raptor? I can't remember. I can't remember what it's called. It was a Chinese dromaeosaurid. A very important discovery, very cool. And you guys seemed to really like the video. It was very popular, and it's been months since I've done that. And there's been a few reasons which we'll go through as well. But basically, that kind of content is a big thing I want to do, not just on the channel, but in my life in general. A few of you know my long-term goal in life is to get a second degree. I've got a degree in biomedical science. I'm going to go back and get another degree and hopefully do a master's in paleontology. And eventually, what I want to do is basically become the Richard Attenborough. Richard, not David. Or was it David and not Richard? David Attenborough. David Attenborough off dinosaurs. You know, I want to host a TV program where we... I'm going to explain, actually. We'll hide that for a minute. We'll bring that back in a minute. So my goal in life, which the channel is going to be a big part of in a lot of ways, because you guys are going to be my audience, hopefully. This is Earth, in case you can't tell by the fact it looks nothing like Earth. But this is Earth. There's Europe, and there's Asia, and there's Africa. I don't know why Africa's not connected to Europe, but they had a falling out. You know, they're not friends anymore. So my goal is eventually to host a TV program, which is kind of part David Attenborough nature documentary and kind of part Walking with Dinosaurs. So the idea would be, we'd pick a dig site. Let's say Hell's Creek, which is in Arizona. I don't know the US at all. Over here, let's guess. That's probably not. But let's say Hell's Creek is here. So we go to Hell's Creek. And we'd focus an episode entirely on Hell's Creek. So let's say it's an hour long. We spend half of it focusing on talking to paleontologists. This is what a paleontologist looks like. He has a hat and a pipe. Don't know why he has a pipe, but he does. We talk to paleontologists about their work, the exciting discoveries they've made recently, what they'd potentially like to see in the future, and maybe discuss some topics, like contentious points within the paleontological community, such as Spinosaurus, at the moment Dimetrodon, the whole malarkey with Triceratops, you guys know what I mean, that kind of thing. And then we'd spend the last half of the episode doing a Walking with Dinosaurs style program, you know, 3D model dinosaurs, blah, 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 very realistically represented as much as we know about dinosaurs at that point in time, so feathers and etc, etc, spines on Triceratops potentially, stuff like that. But it would center completely on Hell's Creek. So it would be basically, I've got visions in my head, you know, you'd pan across the desert version of Hell's Creek, the current modern Hell's Creek, you'd pan across it in a camera, and it would slowly form and mould into this 3D generated, prehistoric, Pangaic Hell's Creek, you know, the approximate location, you know, turning into this forest, woodland, whatever, and we do an episode like Walking with Dinosaurs, in that kind of style, but centred entirely around the creatures and behaviours that would have existed within Hell's Creek. That's kind of the dream. Walking with Dinosaurs, whilst not strictly that accurate these days, was a big thing for me, along with Jurassic Park and stuff like that, because even though you look back and you think Jurassic Park in particular wasn't even up to date on current scientific knowledge in a lot of ways about dinosaurs, it was a piece of entertainment first and foremost. It really got so many people excited about paleontology and dinosaurs, and I can guarantee there are a number of paleontologists out there right now who are paleontologists because they watched Jurassic Park and they fell in love. And I can guarantee there's a lot of you watching this video right now who are watching this video because you're on the channel because you watched Jurassic Park or Walking with Dinosaurs or whatever and you fell in love. And I don't think we've had something like that. We've had Jurassic World. But other than that, I don't think we've had something like that as a community for a very, very long time. And that's really what I want to do. That's what I'm really passionate about. Love Heart is bringing paleontology, breaking it down a bit, making it more accessible to a wider audience, but getting them interested in the hard science side of it as well. So, to that end, very roundabout way of saying all this, the house that sits upon the foundation of games that we're going to experiment with a bit more in this year is going to be sort of more, how do I draw educational content? We'll give them a monocle. Smart people have monocles. That's science. And a top hat, obviously, because he's a dapper son of a gun. I haven't said the word dapper in such a long time. There we go. The Dapper House. And that kind of educational content, like Pangea today, more stuff when I get in front of camera and just talk to you guys about new things, try to get people passionate, excited about paleontology again, because it's a fairly dying breed of science, to be honest, guys. There's very little jobs, there's very few courses you can actually do on it. You know, in the UK, there's like 3 degrees of paleontology, you know, where every university will do an English degree, 3 do paleontology, because people don't care. That's just the way it is. I talk to most people saying, yeah, I want to be a paleontologist, and they're like, it's either the responses are either, what's that, or, oh, like Ross of Friends. People just don't know what it is. It isn't widely known, and people aren't that excited about it, and Jurassic World will help, but I want to push that. I really want to be... That's what I'm passionate about, is what I'm trying to say. And that is going to be hopefully reflected on the channel via weekly paleontology Pangea Today videos and some other stuff. I'd love to do a dino fact file kind of thing, but I know there's somebody out there who does something called Pangea Profiles, I believe, which are absolutely fantastic, really, really well made, very educational. And so it seems a little bit pointless to maybe do the exact same thing. But I've got some other ideas knocking about. So anyway, it's that kind of educational... Not even educational, but just different content, you know, top 10 biggest dinosaurs, and we'll go and we'll talk about them for 20 minutes and we'll see what these dinosaurs would have done and how they would have lived. You know, that kind of stuff is going to hopefully become more common. One reason I am waiting until I move flat is just because I want to get in front of camera to do a lot of this stuff a little bit more. I want a proper camera setup, something I can't do in my very small, dark flat. Anyway, educational, or I don't know, educational is not purely the goal, it's part of it, but entertaining, in front of camera, dinosaurs, stuff that isn't just gaming, you know, I just want to spread out a little bit. I've got ideas, like, for Halloween, I had this little idea of, like, a skit that was going to take 4 or 5 days, like, little video horror film idea I had, which we're going to do next year instead now, but just stuff like that. I'd love to just, I just want to push it in that direction, if you know what I mean. There's no more to the house. That's basically the house. However, there is one more series I want to do called The Creature Feature. I've been talking about this for a long time as well. My favourite type of film is horror films. Within horror films as a genre, my favourite type of film is any film where humans are eaten by animals. I don't know why I have an obsession with this. Lake Placid, Eight-Legged Freak, is that film where this woman has a tiger in her house for some reason. They're usually typically awful. And I can't Jurassic Park in this. It's not horror, but it is a creature feature. Godzilla, etc. They're usually fairly awful films in lots of ways. I don't know why you're so happy about a crocodile eating you, but you are a happy little chap, aren't you? Make him sarcastic. Like, so what, Mr. Crocodile? What are you going to do? Are you going to eat your face? So what I'd like to do is weekly as well, along with Pangea Today. And what I'd like is, I'm kind of rambling in case you can't tell. I love the idea of having a few weekly series that you guys can count on. You know, Saturday, you know to log on and you'll have an episode of Pangea Today. Friday, you know you'll log on and you'll have an episode of The Creature Feature. And this may be fortnightly or whatever, but I kind of want to establish a bit of a schedule. And it's going to mean we're going to play less games at a time, but more of each game. So you wouldn't have to wait like 4 days between an episode of each game, kind of thing. Anywho, I think that's about it for plans. What I'd love to hear from you guys is if there's anything you'd really love to see. So the idea is to become a little bit more professional. The channel is going to be rebranded. You're going to see a new banner. You're going to see a new logo and stuff like that. It's still going to be a sloth with a top hat. Don't panic. Liddy is going nowhere. But hopefully it's going to mean more videos with me in front of the camera. This is a camera, don't argue with me. more videos with, so if I have a shoulder, let's pretend I have shoulders. A Sliddy sitting on my shoulder, god that's a terrifying picture. There's going to be Pangea Today, there's going to be Creature Feature, hopefully more stuff like this, and less games, but more dedicated to each game, if that makes sense. Minecraft Dinosaurs and JPOG will both be coming within the next couple of months. JPOG in January, once Suicide Coon 2 has ended. Minecraft Dinosaurs once Torok ends. That's kind of the plan right now. Bloody hell. Apologies. It's like 6:30 in the morning. I can't handle this right now. That's kind of the plan. The one thing I want to hear from you guys is, similar to Pangea today, similar to the creature feature, is there anything you guys want to see? You know, it's important. I'm here for you guys at the end of the day. If you guys aren't entertained, then I am not doing my job. Which means this video is probably not doing my job. I really want you guys to be happy with the channel and what I'm doing, and I really want, you know, I've formed a good connection with quite a lot of you. There's some of you who I see in every single video, and it makes me so happy seeing these names pop up over and over again. And maybe you just joined a week ago, and that's awesome as well. I really hope you become a member of the great little community we've got here, which will never, ever be the biggest community on our planet. I'm never going to be a 10 million subscriber YouTuber. I'm never going to be PewDiePie. I'm never going to be even similar to a couple of people in the same genre as myself. That's just the way it is, and I'm okay with that. As long as you guys are happy. As long as you guys know that when you come to this channel, you can expect certain things. And to that end, again, I'd love to see suggestions from you guys, certain things you'd love to see. Not necessarily games, we've got so many games planned already for the coming year, but just, you know, what do you want from me? What can I do to make you guys happy? Because that's what matters. I'm making myself happy, but this kind of stuff. I'm really excited about the creature feature. I should be more excited about Pangea today, because it's going to be cool, and it's kind of what I'm passionate about. I'm going to bring paleontology. Oh, also, I forgot to mention. Sorry, I do have an idea for another series. So there's Pangea today, but I'd also like to do a Paleontology Deconstructed is the working title, but I don't love it. Basically, where we take an aspect of paleontology, let's say, and just the classification of dinosaurs, you know, we've got varying different types of trees, which I've completely forgotten the name of, or whatever. But I'll do some research, and basically the idea is to break down paleontological ideas into a digestible form for you guys at home, and we'll do, like, little educational videos, and we'll probably draw them like this, and it'll be awful in many ways, and I'll stand in front of a camera and look like a tool, but that kind of thing. So that's going to be, there's going to be three, hopefully, weekly series as this is, that aren't gaming based, which still leaves a good like 15 episodes of gaming, tons of gaming still, but this is somewhat a direction I want to move into, and I really don't want to panic people who are like, oh, it's changing, everything's changing, it's going to be a couple episodes a week, and even then I might forget eventually, but it's like, yeah, am I making sense? The gaming is not going away. We will always have games running, we'll always have multiple games running. Always dinosaur games, always non-dinosaur games. We're going to have a great 2016, folks. My goal, minimum 400, maximum probably 500. Let's hope we hit it. And I just want to thank you all one more time for joining me. Hopefully you're excited about the plans for the new year. Three new types of series, the return of JPOG, the return of Minecraft Dinosaurs, and some very exciting dinosaur and non-dinosaur games to land in the rest of the year. This is my second attempt making this video. Hopefully this is better than the first one. It is longer, somehow, but whatever. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.